Everyone, now we are learning with the C programming, and I will tell you some of the basics about it, which are very much important. Now, first of all, if I go with the introduction part, this is the introduction of C programming. You see, the C programming language was developed by the Bell Laboratories or Bell Labs in 1972 by the Dennis Ritchie. That we have already learned about it in our very first lecture. C programming language features which were derived from the earlier language, which is called B. So there was a B language which was earlier developed, and out of which the C is taken. And there is BCPL, which is the part of B language, that is Basic Combined Programming Language. So all of you must know one thing, that these things will help you. So that's why we are discussing all these things. Okay. So then we are going that for what the C was developed. The C language was invented and implemented for the Unix operating system. First of all, the C was implemented for the Unix operating system. So that is somehow the very basic thing. Then how that C was further taken through in the market. Now in 1978, the Dennis Ritchie and Baron Carney published the first edition. The name was C programming language, and commonly known as K&RC. The C was not there earlier as the normal C, it was K&RC, right? Because that is from Carney and the Ritchie, right? So K&R was taken from there. Then further, in 1983, there was the NC. NC stands for American National Standard Institute. So NC established a committee that provide the modern and comprehensive definition of C. And then it was named as the NCC in the 1988. So there, from which one the C was started. Now, C is a middle level language. See, all of you, let us suppose that this one is our machine. Okay. The machine basically work on some 0 and 1. Okay. And that we name is at the binary language. Right. So, machine work on the binary language, or we also say it as it is working on the machine language. Okay. Now, in this machine language, whatever the language works, means this is, you assume that this is a total machine, okay, total hardware. Now on this hardware, there is some language which work, which can directly interact with the machine, with those 0 and 1, that is called your machine language or binary language or low level language. So anything, any language which coordinate directly with the machine is called the low level language, binary language or machine language. So that language will only be working on 0 and 1s. Then further, on the top level, where the user is there. So this one is the user. Now user, you know that we all are the users. So user is going to interact with the normal English languages. Now that English language, or maybe those sentences are there, that is called the high level language, and there it is the 0 and 1. Okay. So in between high level language and low level language, there is the language which is going to provide the communication, and which is having the both features, that is called the middle level language. So C is the middle level language. C stands at this location, which also deals with high level language as well as the low level language. So it is the middle level language because it combines the best elements of low level, machine level with the high level language. Okay, so C comes there. Then talking about C programming language, C programming language is the structured programming language. And as we know that whenever something is well defined, control and provide the modularity, then that comes into the structure. So C is a structured programming language, which means that it allows to develop program with well defined control. Means the user is having the control on their programs and provide the modularity. Modularity, we know that whenever there is a big program, now that big program is divided into small parts. Let us suppose that this is module 1, this is module 2. Modules are nothing but the small functions and up to so on. So this one is called the modularity, breaking up the multiple subtasks that are simple enough to understand and reuse. Let us suppose that I am having a program where sum is required. If I am again saying A plus B, then again saying B plus C, D plus C, so many times I am making the plus thing, then I can simply use a module where I can apply a function of sum. So that is called the modularity, and this will be the better option rather than doing all these sums multiple times. Okay, so that is called the modularity, and the well-defined control make the C programming as the structured programming language. See, whenever you make the program there, let us suppose that I am making the program of 20 pages. Now that program will not be so much meaningful, but if I divide that program of 20 pages into small part, let us suppose that the coding for your sum function is there, the coding for negative function is there. I am making a real life example. Let us suppose that you are having a window, you are developing a window, and you are having a 20 pages of coding of window where you cannot find anything. That is a very problematic. But if I say this area is having only the coding of clock, the window clock, this is having the coding of your start menu, this one is having the coding of something else, right? So this is called the modularity. So whenever there is thing in the small parts and combine them, this is called modularity.